Hi folks, Larry here from canhamtrailers.com, mobile tech, and today we're going to talk about tarping our trailer. I get asked quite a bit about tarping, how I tarp my trailers, and basically you want to cover whatever is going to be exposed, and you want to think about later on when you might have the skin off too. So you want to buy a tarp that will almost completely cover the trailer. You want to be able to go from basically the skirt boards all the way around. Now this trailer here, I'm using a couple of tarps that I already had, so it's not completely down to the skirt boards, but it's unnecessary because we're not removing the skin from this trailer anyway. This trailer will be flipped, and hopefully it will go to one of the, wait for the noise to go by here. Hopefully it will go to one of the parks that are starting to pop up all over the country. Vintage RV parks where they have nothing but vintage trailers in there, and you can rent them to stay in for the night like a bed and breakfast. But at any rate, I just wanted to show you, cover the trailer over this way with your tarp and use a good tarp. If you go to Home Depot, you're just going to get junk that only lasts 30 days and then it starts to rip and tear because it gets eaten up in the sun. And I firmly believe that they actually build them that way on purpose, to be eaten up in the sun. I use Tarps Direct only. Tarps Direct. You can find them online, tarpsonline.com. These are the silver poly tarps. They have lasted me up to 3 years in the hot desert sun. And they're not that much more expensive than the big box stores tarps for the same size. And even including shipping, they're not that much more. So they're well worth the money. But at any rate, here's one of the things that I've done. You may have seen this before. You can open the tarp up and work on the trailer and actually use the tarp for shade. It's early in the morning and I've got the sun straight in front of me. But for most of the day, this will provide a little bit of shade. I'm working on this window here. I'm getting this trailer ready for sale. So whenever I get a trailer ready for sale, I fix all the glass in it. That way when it's traveling to its new home, we don't have any problems with wind or bugs or anything else getting inside. So I get all the glass fixed. So I'm working on this window over here. I removed it yesterday and I just wanted, you know, a little shade. I don't want to de-tarp the trailer because we get thunderstorms here all the time. So it's easy enough for me to just drop this tarp back down if I see a storm coming, tie it off, and go back to work on it later. So I don't have to completely de-tarp the trailer, and I can pull the sides up or the back up or the front up anytime I want to in order to work on the trailer. So the only thing you can't work on really is the roof when it's completely tarped like this. But the tarps can also be rolled back halfway and rolled forward halfway. So you don't have to always take your tarp completely off your trailer, especially if you're working outside and you have no hard cover above you. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and finish getting this window fixed. And then I will be putting this trailer up for sale online on Craigslist. I've already talked to a few park owners, vintage park owners. They show an interest in it, so it may end up with one of those people. But that's just something I wanted to show you. People are always asking me about how I tarp my trailers, and I wanted to show you how I did it, what I use, and where I got them from. Another thing you can do to make things simple, instead of always tying the tarp down underneath the trailer, because that's what you have to do. You have to run lines down underneath here and there. I usually, on most trailers, because usually all I work on is the smaller 15 to 18 footers, I have one line going underneath, usually right around the wheels somewhere, to hold the middle down. That way, even in wind, the tarp won't go anywhere. I can flop the back up over this way, flop it back down, And I can do the same thing with the front, but if you leave the center lines tied, that tarp won't go anywhere. The hardest thing to do is tarp a trailer by yourself. Let's go to the rear and I'll show you diapering what I mean by that. Now on both the rear and the front of the trailer, you should diaper it, and there's two ways to do that. You can fold the sides around this way, tie everything down. Here I'm using the license plate holder, and in the front I would use the tongue for this. I want to get the center held down, and then the two sides diapered around that and held together like this, and it won't go anywhere and it keeps everything dry. Again, you want to, if you're buying a tarp for a specific trailer, you want this to cover all the way down to the skirt boards. The same with both sides. In this case, it's unnecessary because I'm not removing this skin, so I just use tarps that I already had here. Okay? Now the other way to do this, let me show you. This is the way you would do it if the wind is coming, hitting the front of the trailer and coming around this way. Now if the wind is hitting, we're talking about prevailing winds here, most of the direction that the hard wind usually comes from in storms. If the wind were hitting it this way, we would fold these sides around to the side. Instead of diapering this way, this would be folded over to the side. I'll take you to another trailer and show you that. All right, now because the wind generally comes from this direction, I diaper off to the sides in the front, and then I diaper around the back in the rear. So in the front, it's basically the same thing except pulled to the side instead of pulled around to the front. And in this case, I just go back and tie it off at the wheels, okay? You again have something in the center tied off at all times, and then the rear I have diapered the way I just showed you. So this is what you're thinking about, is the direction that the wind usually comes from, the heavy winds. And so this way, no air can catch anything. It's just nice and flat. If you had it diapered this way, wind could get in there and catch it and do some damage to the tarp or to your lines or whatever. This is really good, thick, heavy-duty tarp. It's UV resistant, and like I say, it's a silver poly, because you have a lot of choices, both in the material type and the color. And I use the silver poly, and I've been doing that for years. I used to work under tarps before I got my building, and I can't fit all my trailers in the building, so I still have to use tarps on trailers that might potentially leak until they get completely finished. So this way I can work on the trailer, keep the tarp on it, and then fold it back. So when I'm working on the front, I'll just undo the front and flop it over, and I'll work on the front all the way back to the center connection. And when I'm working on the rear, I can do the same thing. If the roof comes off of this trailer, we'll tarp it the same way. It just won't have any aluminum up there. And then I can, like I say, work on the front by folding it back, and I can put it back here. The same with the rear. So it's pretty simple, and it's a really good way to work if you don't have a building to work in. A lot of people don't. Anyway, that's tarping your trailer with Mobile Tech from canhamtrailers.com. We'll see you next time. Enjoy yourselves, and remember, I make mistakes so you don't have to.